I'm a little messed up.
So, I've been home for at least 20 minutes now.
Your point?
Where's my hello kiss?
What a kiss? Why don't you just kiss me?
No, I don't want it now.
What do you mean you don't want it now?
I had to ask for it, so it's not the same.
What do you mean it's not the same? Or was it on me to kiss you?
I arrived home and you're already here.
What rule was that?
Everybody knows that that's a rule.
Zoe, you just made this crap up.
The person that arrives home gets greeted with the kiss.
So the next time your sister comes over, I'm meant to grab her and snog her?
That's completely different.
Oh, so only you and your mum get the tongue.
You're disgusting. How hard is it to greet your wife with a kiss?
How hard is it for you to come home and not be a complete nutcase?
That's annoying. Who pops a plug hole out of someone's desk? The human has to reach over and put it back in? Okay, back to work. Fuck off! Tell the cat you specifically want the plug kept in. Respect the boundaries! Super glue it! Use your highly evolved human brain to outsmart the feline. Gaffer tape it down. Do what you have to do. Okay, buy a new desk.
What are we driving?
Hey, True, bet that up for the track. We'll take it to the top, and that's the truth. True first.
This is our first time in Thailand. Have you got any suggestions?
Yeah, Pat Pong is good. They got really good rubber and puggy, but some places only do rubber, not sake.
No, I don't think so. We're more into art and culture.
Yes. Oh, yeah, like shows?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they got the ping pong pussy show. They shoot ping pongs from their moots, I swear to God.
Okay, that's enough. We'll be getting you some brochures.
What's the first thing you think about when you wake up?
A wank, I think.
Learning to walk, fucked on by the cat. Learning to run, fucked on by the cat. Playing hide and seek, fucked on by the cat. Dinner's ready, fucked on by the cat. Christmas time, fucked on by the cat. Eaten alive, playing football, fucked on by the cat.
Since arriving at the rescue, Jen has had a very busy past few days. Our first mission was trying to get all those mats out of her hair while avoiding having to cut it all off. So that meant a lot of detangler and a whole lot of brushing. The hair that ended up coming off was no longer attached and was actually just matted into the rest of her mane from not being brushed in who knows how long. The very next day, she saw our farrier and got a much-needed pedicure done. The whole time he was doing it, she was absolutely wonderful and never once had any issues. We're so proud of her. Then this afternoon, we decided to try and tackle her tail, which is just as matted, if not more, than what her mane was. I also love that her mane is still long. It just makes me so happy. And this is her tail. It's super matted. So, we went to work on it, started out with the detangler, and did a whole lot of brushing. We were trying to get it all out without having to cut much of it, but we did end up having to cut the two worst ones just because they were so bad. We also worked on getting a lot of her loose top coat off. We had to do this very easily because horses that are this underweight can be very sensitive to sharp and hard brushes. I did notice some rain rot, which is basically just a fungal infection horses get on their skin, so I went ahead and treated that. Yes, I am just in love with her tail now, but I'm so proud of how well she's done so far, and I cannot wait to see how she does in time. Thank you everyone that has supported and followed her journey, and look at that mane, just like Rapunzel.
My.
Hi, my name is Brian. I'm 33 years old and I'm in a relationship with my 12 volt impact driver. How are you today, little monkey?
Brian is in a committed relationship with a cordless drill that he's named Kenneth.
My dad came home from work and that was the first time I met Kenneth. He had Kenneth with him to fix our garden shed. After he'd done using him, he left him outside overnight. And I could see him out there, and I could see that he needed me. No one had ever needed me before, you know? So that vulnerability was very attractive to me straight away from Kenneth. So, you know, call it fate, you know, destiny, you know, written in the stars as all that, so whatever.
Of course, it was hard telling friends and family that your husband had left you for one of his tools. And they were just close friends at first. Kenneth, he would come with us everywhere. You know, birthday parties, summer holidays, Christmas dinner, Pizza Hut. He was always there. He was Kenneth. He was part of the family.
I don't think I'd be the man I am today without Kenneth. Truthfully. Yeah.
Brian's love for Kenneth.
Here, across. Okay, ready? Do this. I'm a big printer. I'm a play
digger. Yeah, I am what I am. I don't have no time. And then what? Sorry.
Start again. Go. Yeah!
Cool. Thank you. Dude. You have a fridge in your room?
I try to be prepared to go a week straight without leaving my room, so I need some provisions.
Surely you have to go to the restroom at some point during a 7-day stretch.
There's no need to go anywhere. I use plastic bottles.
No way. Did she really?
If it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
I was washing my face, I breathed the bubbles on my nose holes, and it felt like it went into my brain. And it burned! It's like I just inhaled 2 billion gallons of the spiciest peppers in the world. Just like...
Passing every red light.